Honorable Chairman, distinguished panelists, and my dear friends, greetings of the day. As we all know, cement industry is one of the most important primary and basic industry for the economic development of the country. It is a basic industry that makes an important contribution to the development of the other industries, and being a key infrastructure industry directly impacts the construction industry. India is the second largest cement producer in the world and accounted for over 8% of the global installed capacity as of 2019. The Government of India is strongly focused on infrastructure development to boost economic growth, and India is in an aggressive phase of development in the infrastructure and construction sector, and the cement industry is prepared to meet the growing requirements. With a total of more than 200 large cement plants, accounting for a cumulative installed capacity of over 410 million tons and around 350 small plants spread across the country, cement industry is well positioned to cater to the requirements of construction industry in every nook and corner of the country. Cement production reached around 329 million tons in FY20 and is projected to reach 381 million tons by FY22. India's overall cement production being nearly 545 million tons in FY20. As with most parts of the world, India is also trying to respond to the challenges of the post-COVID-19 reality, which has come to define a new normal for our economy and the society and the world at large. The infrastructure and construction sectors, which are primarily contributing to India's growth story, are continuing to face the headwinds from the COVID-19 pandemic and are not insulated from its damaging impact. Investment in capital projects drives the demand side of the construction sector, and hence the impact of COVID-19 pandemic on GDP will be significant in the near to long term, as we are already seeing. The demand for construction projects has fallen due to the reduced business sentiments, lower operating surpluses, diversion of some funds for COVID-19 management, and credit and liquidity problems. While lower economic activity in other sectors impact construction services through forward linkages, a fall in construction output has a multiplier effect through the sector's backward linkages, creating a vicious cycle in overall economic activity. The project implementation cost may not vary much for linear projects like irrigation canals, pipelines, transmission lines, roads, etc. But for the non-linear projects, the cost may increase. Projects that are under development have taken a hit with delays due to the impact from the pandemic. COVID-19 is a unique and one-of-a-kind event that has impacted not just construction but hampered all major businesses linked within the project value chain. Recovery in the construction sector and meeting project timelines and budgets are critical to the revival of overall economy. The construction industry in India accounts for around 8% of the nation's GDP and is one of the largest employers. Also, being a core sector, there are numerous industries that are dependent on the construction activity in the country. Government, contractors, and vendors have to collectively play their parts to ensure continued revival in the overall construction ecosystem. This is where cement industry plays its role of being the crucial supplier of the key ingredient, cement. And cement has been a reliable indicator of economic activity. Cement industry was one of the initial industries to combat the challenges of COVID-19 and restart production and distribution operations as early as April, after all the economic activities had come to standstill from March due to the countrywide lockdown. Overcoming the initial challenges, majorly in the logistics operations of cement, that is inbound, outbound, primary and secondary transportation, among other challenges. This aided the construction industry to restart its activities, with the key input material, cement, being made available. Thus, sustained dispatches over 6 months provides a basis for newfound optimism. We can be confident that the cement industry has very well coped up with the situation and bounce back with resilience, returning to pre-COVID levels or even better, and is ready to support the construction industry with full vigor. In the words of Honorary Chairman, the industry is geared up to partner with India's dream of 5 trillion economy. This is further buttressed by trends visible in urban construction and infrastructure projects. Resumption of infrastructure projects in a big way is a great source of confidence. It also demonstrates the government's resolve to kickstart the economy. The same is true for other projects as well. The Reserve Bank of India's interventions on injecting liquidity in the system have worked well. In the real estate sector, builders are restarting work on old projects and announcing new ones. This is to get the working capital cycle going on the back of lower housing loan interest. The next wave should be urban and semi-urban affordable housing. Now let me talk about cement and climate change and sustainability. Cementing a green India. Cement is an integral component for the construction industry and will continue to occupy supreme position in foreseeable future due to its low cost and easy availability. The production and use of cement causes adverse effects on natural resources, environment, sustainability, and climate change. The challenge before the present generation is how to minimize these adverse impacts and how to make cement greener. It is estimated that contribution of construction globally in generation of greenhouse gases is about 7%, which is fourth highest after thermal power generation, transportation, and agriculture. The building industry in general and cement-based construction in particular are responsible to consume large amounts of earth's mineral resources, causing cascading effects on environment and sustainability. The use of cement is accelerating worldwide and likely to continue for next couple of decades due to increasing construction activity, especially in developing countries like India. It is estimated that during 2020, nearly 2 billion tons of concrete and more than 350 million tons of cement have been used in India. The consumption of both cement and concrete is likely to grow further at a CAGR of 6-8% during the period from 2020 to 2030. Cement, amongst other construction materials, is responsible for releasing maximum carbon dioxide and other gaseous emissions in the atmosphere during its production. Production of 1 ton of Portland cement results in emission of nearly 0.8 tons of carbon dioxide, which has negative impact on environment and contributes to heating up of our planet Earth and consequent climate change. The foremost measure to reduce the harmful emissions in production of cement is to bring down percentage of clinker in its composition. Noteworthy efforts have been made during the last few decades in India to use alternative cementitious materials like fly ash, GGBS, silica fume, calcined clay, metakaolin, and limestone powder as part replacement of clinker. Though the use of alternative cementing materials have been found beneficial not only from environment point of view but also from economic and durability considerations, however, apprehensions still persist for using them to their full potential in India and many other parts of the world. The second important ingredient in use of cement is water. Scarcity of fresh water is becoming evident, especially in tropical countries like India, due to periodic droughts, untimely rains, and increasing demand. Large quantity of fresh water is also required for production and curing of concrete, resulting in shortages for other important purposes like drinking, cleaning, and food production. Conservation of water and minimizing its use in cement-based constructions without affecting its durability is an important aspect of sustainability. Yet another important ingredient of cement-based construction is coarse and fine aggregates, which constitute together about 80% of the total concrete weight. Mining, transporting, and processing of natural stone to produce aggregates has significant impact on the environment. The alternate sources of aggregates from construction and demolition waste, recycling of concrete, municipal solid waste, and other non-conventional sources like sintered fly ash and clay have promised to address this issue to some extent. The role of chemical admixtures, especially to achieve desired workability at low water binder ratio to improve performance and durability of concrete, have important bearing on sustainability. The benefits of other chemical admixtures for corrosion emission, air entrainment, set retardation, surface protection, etc. also have positive effects on sustainability. The negative effects of on environment and sustainability in production and use of cement will be considerably minimized in the coming years through the following measures: continuing efforts to reduce electric and thermal energy in production of cement through innovation, automation and digitization of cement plants, by developing energy efficient grinding systems of raw materials and clinker, as more than 50% electric energy is used in grinding operations, wherein projects like EP100 will go a long way. Maximizing use of electric power produced through renewable resources like solar and wind instead of fossil fuels. Increased use of alternative fuels and raw materials to transfer cement from plant either through rail or road to consumption sites in bulk instead of present practice of bagging in 50 kg bags. To maximize use of supplementary cementitious materials like fly ash and GGBS in cement and concrete, though availability of these materials is becoming a concern. It will be further effectively done by setting split units close to consumption areas where fly ash or GGBS is available, to produce and popularize cements which have least adverse effects on environment, like masonry cement, limestone cement, LC3 and composite cements which have lower percentage of clinker in their composition, to reduce use of cement in concrete by using chemical admixtures, better batching and mixing systems, and use of special concretes like high volume fly ash concrete, aerated concrete, self-compacting and pervious concrete. Shift to performance-based specifications from present practice of using descriptive specifications and life cycle cost analysis of all major civil projects. It is important that all human activities, including cement-based construction, should be in synchronization with the sustainable development in order to meet the basic needs of housing, sanitation, and infrastructure of large segment of population. In recent years, sustainability and climate change and their importance in economic development and human existence have gained high importance globally. During the next decade, cement industry in India will continue to take many more positive measures to reduce the adverse effect of cement on environment and to make it more greener and sustainable. Let me take this opportunity to congratulate CIDC for organizing this very important online international conference and exhibition, India Construction Week 2020. Thank you.